Becca here with one of our CT systems. Today, Ken's going to take us through the importance of slip ring maintenance.
Today, we'll discuss some preventative maintenance tips and specifically focus on the slip ring. So the OEM recommends that we inspect the slip ring twice a year, a minimum of every 6 months during our PM cycle. We should be looking at our high voltage slip rings, our low voltage slip rings, and our data brush slip rings in this particular slip ring system. This happens to be a Siemens Sensation system, so we have this particular configuration. Your configuration may change based on your system. What we want to do is we want to physically inspect and feel for ridges, for imperfections, for identifiable wear on each one of the rings, and we want to do this around the circumference of the entire slip ring. So we should be doing this a minimum of a 360 degree rotation. I prefer to do it two entire rotations because it gives me a greater opportunity to feel any slight imperfection that may exist. Imperfections will decrease the life of your brushes by damaging the tip. So if there is any burring or tracking of each and every one of these rings, you'll actually wear your contact brush faster. You'll create more dust in your environment, and that overall impedes the overall function of your machine. If you would determine that there is a surface imperfection to one of your rings or multiple rings caused by arcing or uneven wear of your brushes, the tool to use is actually what's called an abrasive cleaner pad or an abrasive sponge. This is a fine grit abrasive sanding pad, essentially, that is manufactured specifically to treat the slip ring. These are part of our PM kits that we sell here at Technical Prospects. We also sell them individually if necessary. You use this pad simply to polish the ring of the slip ring. So you would use this in a wide sweeping motion, and you would gently rub it across the slip rings. You would then check for your imperfection. If the imperfection was still there, you would continue to address it. Never use this in aggressive fashion in one particular spot, because you'll actually create a well within the rail itself. The third portion of slip ring maintenance is final cleaning. So after you inspected it visually and by feel, and if you've used the abrasive pad to do any cleaning, lastly, you want to do a general maintenance cleaning, which requires very high grade denatured alcohol. You would first vacuum the slip ring with your HEPA vac. Second, you would apply liberal amounts of denatured alcohol to a lint-free cleaning rag, and you would again use a broad sweeping motion to polish the ring in a circular fashion. Remember that if you're working from the back side of the gantry, you rotate the gantry in a counterclockwise rotation if necessary, so that you continue the rotation of the system in the proper direction. Gloves. Remember to wear gloves when you're working with the slip ring or brushes. We do not want to contaminate the ring surface with body oils or lotions or anything that we may have on our hands. Second of all, from a safety standpoint, we do not want to create carbon wear on our hands as well. We don't want our bodies to ingest any of that if not necessary. Thank you.
Give us a call for any tech support or if you're in need of any of these parts. Subscribe, like us on Facebook, and we'll see you next time.